Let us now get into the second topic of the session. In this topic, we will be talking about Porter's five force analysis of competition. What does Porter say? He says, competitive rivalry within an industry exists always. So in a particular industry, let's say it is a footwear industry. So competitive rivalry in the footwear industry does exist. Now what happens is the bargaining power of the suppliers happens if the supplier or the person who's supplying the product is stronger to the company or the organization where he supplies. Now, for example, let's say a particular supplier is more financially sound, or is a bigger company. The supplier is a bigger company, and the person purchasing from the supplier is a small organization. When the organization is small, the bargaining power of the supplier is much higher. The bargaining power of the customer also becomes higher when the demand for the product is more, or when the competition, or when more number of products of the similar type are available, then the bargaining power of the customer becomes more. Now, for example, let's take the vegetable market. In the vegetable market, you have people selling the vegetables, or number of people selling vegetables. When number of people are selling vegetables, the bargaining power of the customer increases in this particular situation, because more number of people are ready to sell the same type of vegetable. So the bargaining power definitely is a big force as far as the competition is concerned. So we need to analyze this bargaining power as far as the competition is concerned. Then the next aspect that Porter talks about is the threat of new companies, new products starting to being launched in the market. Now, let's say you have a product, it's a cosmetic product. There is always a threat that a new company would come out with a similar type of product that you are marketing in the market today. So that is another very, very important aspect that needs to be considered. And apart from that, there is also a threat of substitute products that could be available. Now, a substitute product could be in the form of, use this product instead of this product. Now, use this hair oil instead of this hair oil. So it could be any type of substitute product. It could be either an imitative product, or it could be a product that can be easily substituted by the other product. Now, for example, instead of a two-wheeler, you can have a four-wheeler as a substitute product. Instead of having your own vehicle, you can have a taxi as a substitute product to move from one place to another place. So there is always a threat, because substitute products could come into the market, which could provide the advantage to the customer in the form of price or quality or whatever it is. So Porter clearly says that we need to analyze, as far as competition is concerned, these five forces that always acts on an organization. All these five forces always acts on an organization. So the bargaining power of the supplier is always there. The supplier tries to pull out as much as possible from an organization when he supplies a product. The customer tries to get the best out of an organization when they're buying a product. They don't want to just pay the money for the sake of paying. They want value from that particular organization. So they try to get the best. Now, for example, let's say you go into a mall to buy, or go into a particular place to buy a television. You try to bargain. The customer tries to bargain for whatever lower price that is possible, so that he gets the best price or the best amount of discount that is possible as far as the product is concerned. Apart from this, there is always a threat of a new product entering into the market, and threat of substitute products that could always enter into the market. So what Porter actually says is that you need to analyze these five forces that always acts on a particular organization, because in a competitive situation, in a competitive scenario, if you don't take care of these five forces, then you will not be successful as far as growth of the organization is concerned.